welcome or welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're gonna talk about vitamin D. I will literally cover everything you need to know about vitamin D, and you will also know by the end of this video how to calculate your own personalized usage of vitamin D, like an actual nutritionist. So I'm gonna teach you all of that by the end of this video. So if you're ready, grab a pen and paper and let's get started.
3, 2, 1.
By the way, if you guys are new here, my name is Seppi and I made this whole channel on healthy, sustainable weight loss. So if that's something you're into, make sure you give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, hit the bell button so you never miss a video from me. I'm also doing a giveaway of an air fryer by September 30th, 2021. So if you're watching this video on time, make sure you follow the instructions that I'm gonna mention later in this video. Before we start, I wanted to let you guys know that you don't need to waste your money on vitamins and supplements. If you're eating a healthy diet, if you're exercising regularly, and you have a low body fat percentage, you are not most likely going to need to supplement on any vitamins or minerals whatsoever. But vitamin D is a little bit different. That's why I wanted to make this video for you guys. First, let's understand who really needs vitamin D. According to research, over 50% of people in the United States are deficient in vitamin D. And a higher percentage of that includes a lot of elderly, a lot of women with higher body fat percentages, and also people that have darker skin tone. Supplements are for specific people who are following specific diets that really exclude some of the food groups. For example, if you're lactose intolerant and you can't have milk or dairy, then you're gonna be low on calcium. And if you're not getting your green vegetables every single day and you're not getting enough calcium, you might have to supplement on it. And for vitamin D as well, let's say if you're like me and you live in Canada and you're not getting enough sunlight every single day and you don't eat a lot of fatty fish every single day, that's when you need to supplement on it. But obviously it's much, much better if you get your vitamins and minerals from actual food, because food has fiber and it slows down your digestion, so your body has time to extract the vitamins properly and what it needs from the food and digest it properly, as opposed to when you get a tablet, you don't know where that's gonna go, how fast it's gonna get digested. It depends on what's going on in there. Are you gonna get it or are you not gonna get it? So you don't want to take the chance. It's always better to stick with food, and I'm gonna tell you what kind of vitamin D rich food you need to include in your diet every single day. How would you know if you have vitamin D deficiency? You're not gonna be able to get a blood test every single day, you know what I mean? During winter, especially when you feel sad, depressed, moody, if you have joint pain, muscle pain, and you feel achy, you might be low in vitamin D actually. So make sure you remember to take that. Every single one of my friends during winter time, when they tell me, oh, I don't feel like myself, I always tell them, did you take vitamin D? And honestly, the answer is always no. So make sure you keep an eye on that. And let's say if you're not sure and you really wanna get a blood test, you could do that. You can ask for the exact amount of vitamin D in your blood, the actual concentration, and it has to be 20 nanogram per milliliter. I'm gonna make it very basic for you. If you're not in the sun, if you're wearing sunscreen and you're not having salmon or sardines or fatty fish, liver and organs every single day, you are gonna be deficient in vitamin D. So make sure you get tested and make sure that you're not deficient in it. Now, before I really get into the details of how to calculate the dosage, I wanna tell you what the role of vitamin D is in your body. The role of vitamin D is to regulate your blood levels of calcium, phosphorus, and a little bit of magnesium. It does play a huge role in your bone health, especially as you get older, so that's something to look out for, but I'm sure you've heard of this one. The most important role of vitamin D is in your immune function. So if you feel like you're getting sick a lot, that means that your vitamin D is not really playing the role that it should be in your body, because it is what really protects your cells from entering virus into your cells. Another thing that is under debate for vitamin D, that it does help with your glucose metabolism. So basically what happens is that when you have a full meal of carbs, right after you still feel hungry, because vitamin D is not playing its role of metabolizing that glucose in your food. However, since there's so many different factors that play a role in glucose metabolism, it's pretty unfair to link vitamin D only to that. But people that are not metabolizing glucose properly are linked to vitamin D deficiency as well. There are so many different and conflicting researches out there that will drive you nuts. For example, I was looking at this meta-analysis that considers a bunch of research, 195 to be exact, and out of those, they selected 12 of them and they narrowed it down and they looked at it and they noticed that there is no link between vitamin D3 supplementation and insulin sensitivity. So that's something about supplements, just so you know. There was another research done on 70 overweight women that were trying to lose weight. They gave half of them them vitamin D supplementation, and the other half nothing, a placebo pill, which is like a fake pill. And then they measured their weight loss results, and the group that took vitamin D3 lost more fat mass but really didn't change in size. So looking at this, I'm not going to tell you that vitamin D is going to make you lose fat or anything like that, but it will definitely keep you healthy and will keep your system as a whole healthy and running, your immune system, your glucose metabolism, and basically your health and your bones and everything else. So there are two different types of vitamin D supplementations. There's D2 and D3. D3 is known to be more effective. It comes from animals and animal products, but D2, it comes from plants, and it's a different type of vitamin D, and it doesn't get absorbed as well as D3. I personally use the D3 tablets, which I like. There are actually oil drops that you could use for vitamin D as well. And there's another favorite that I have, is cod liver oil. Cod liver oil has D3 as well as vitamin A, so I do really dig recommend that. It's not the most ethical way of getting your vitamins, because they go through this horrible process extracting that oil. That's why I don't use it, but it is very effective. For the rest of this video, I will teach you how to actually calculate your vitamin D usage. The first thing you're gonna do is to go to a National Institution of Health website, which I'm gonna show you right now on my computer. The first thing we're going to do is to go on National Institutes of Health website, and then we're going to search for RDA vitamin D, which means recommended dietary allowance. And then the first link, and you can do this for any other vitamin as well, or any other minerals. And then you can scroll down, they're gonna talk about, give you some information about vitamin D. And when you scroll down to this table, you can see what the RDA is. I am a female and I'm between 19 to 50 years old, so my recommended daily allowance is 600 IUs or 15 micrograms. If you actually scroll all the way down to the bottom of the page, you're gonna find another table that tells you what the upper limit of vitamin D is. As you can see on this table, if you're 19 years and older, the maximum intake of vitamin D should be 4,000 IUs or 100 micrograms a day. Another very useful table that you can find on this page is table number 3, which gives you the vitamin D content of all of these selected foods right here. Now that you've actually looked at this website and you know how much vitamin D you need every single day, then you're gonna have to find out how much vitamin D you're getting from your food. Then when you subtract those numbers, you're gonna find out how much you need to supplement on vitamin D, right? Okay, to make this more fun, let's take a look at my diet today and see if I need to supplement on vitamin D. I know that I need 600 IUs or 15 micrograms of vitamin D today, and I've had 2 pasture-raised eggs, which is 1.5 microgram of vitamin D. And I also had 3 ounces of salmon, which is 14 point something microgram of vitamin D, which actually adds up to my requirement. So I'm okay, I don't need to supplement on vitamin D today. But let's say tomorrow, if I'm not gonna have that salmon, I'm only gonna be at 1.5 microgram with this 2 eggs, then I need to supplement on it, right? So that's what I mean to keeping an eye on your diet. Every single day, you don't need to take vitamin D. It's not sufficient to do that. You're wasting money and you're maybe like taking too much vitamin D, which is gonna cause problems later on in your life. So that's not something you wanna do. You wanna make sure you're taking enough vitamin D every single day. And for example, let's say if I took my dog out today and I'd be walked for 20 minutes under the sun and I wasn't wearing sunscreen on my body and I was wearing shorts, I'm okay, I don't need to take vitamin D. Why would I, you know, take extra? Because vitamin D actually gets stored in your fat cells, so there's no point of taking so much of it. Your body is gonna extract more vitamin D as you metabolize the fat throughout the day. Before I continue with the rest of this video, I wanted to tell you guys about the giveaway that is coming up on September 30th, 2021. So if you're watching this video on time, make sure you go on my Instagram, find the post that is related to the giveaway, like it, follow me, tag 3 of your friends, and comment "I'm in," and you will be entered for the draw. I will let you guys know on September 30th who has won the giveaway, and you will be shipped the air fryer by the end of the month. And remember, this contest is only available to people that reside in North America. Good luck, guys. When we're talking about vitamin D, there are a lot of macro and micronutrients that work together to help vitamin D do its job. For example, we have calcium, phosphorus, fluoride, potassium, magnesium. So these are some supplements that you need to keep in mind. But if you're following a healthy meal plan like the one I listed it in the description below. I don't know if you guys have seen it or not. If not, definitely download it. It's a very, very nice and basic guide that tells you what you should be eating every single day to, number one, lose weight, and number two, make sure that you include all the macronutrients and necessary micronutrients in your diet. On top of that, make sure you watch this video. I talk about the greens that you should be having, all the vegetables that you should be including on your daily routine, and it's a very, very good video to watch. I wanted to quickly summarize everything I said in this video. If you are getting enough sunlight, if you're getting enough fatty fish and liver and organs every single day, you don't need to worry about vitamin D. If you're not, make sure you supplement on it, because it's gonna make you moody and it's gonna cause a lot of problems down the line. In terms of supplements, you can go with cod liver oil, which has vitamin A, E, and omega-3 fatty acids, or D3 supplements, which is more effective. And you already read how to calculate how much vitamin D you're getting every single day and how much you need. So I really, really hope this video was useful. Everything you need is linked in the description. All the links that we talked about in this video is underneath there. If you have any questions, make sure you comment them down below. If you like this video and you found it useful, please remember to give it a thumbs up and let me know what kind of content you want to see next. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for subscribing and liking all of my videos. Love you so much. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.